Canadian folklore and ghost stories as retold by author Becca Ferguson. Narrated by Robbie Ferguson. This is the Fort Saskatchewan Wendigo of Alberta. Swift Runner crouched down in the trampled snow next to the dead body of his hunting partner. After weeks of being stranded in ever-accumulating snowdrifts with nothing to eat, Runner was starving. Now, having made up his mind, he pulled a knife from the sheath of his belt, and when the feverish deed was done, he fell asleep with a bloated belly next to the stripped bones of his partner. He awoke in the murk of dawn to a hissing sort of breathing, like a man whose lung had been punctured by an arrow. The sound came from a tall form standing in the gaps between trees, snow falling heavily all around. It moved into the clearing, leaving bloody footsteps in its wake, and peered down at Runner with glowing eyes in a deer-like skull. The smell of decaying flesh wafted from the desiccated body as Runner heard a voice enter his mind saying,
"You have become me."
In the spring of 1879, years later, Swift Runner's estranged Cree community began to question the whereabouts of his wife and five children, who had not been seen by anyone since the early winter. Unsatisfied with Runner's explanation, he claimed they'd all starved to death that winter, and noting his rounded torso, they sent the police in to investigate. After days of searching the woods, a pit of charred wood and ashes was discovered, with human skulls and weathered bones scattered about. A tiny moccasin shoe had been stuffed inside one of the skulls, a beading needle protruding from the eye socket. The police gathered the remains together and determined them to be Runner's missing family, accusing him of cannibalism. He denied nothing, saying, "I did it," and became the first man to be legally hung in the Canadian Northwest Territories. This has been the Fort Saskatchewan Wendigo of Alberta, part of Becca Ferguson's Canadian Folklore and Ghost Stories series. Catch the complete and ever-growing series on Wattpad or directly on the author's website, BeccaFerguson.com. Like, comment, and be sure to subscribe so you don't miss the next tale.